think about the heat waves and flooding and the fires, and we're starting to see species go extinct, sea level rise and ice melting. We've already seen a very different world now than we did a few decades ago.
Climate change matters a lot. In some ways, it is the single biggest challenge humanity has faced. Unlike many challenges of the past, this one will affect all of us.
Pollution doesn't stop on the arbitrary lines on the globe that call this country A and this country B. Pollution is a global issue.
Right now, atmospheric concentrations of carbon dioxide are higher than any time in the last 2 million years. And since 1990, emissions increased by a whopping 54%.
These greenhouse gases have been trapping too much of the sun's energy and heating up the planet. And the great majority come from processes related to energy.
Fossil fuels right now make up 60% of our electricity, and we need to phase that out dramatically and quickly.
With climate change, we need to solve the whole thing. We can't leave 10 to 15% of it unsolved.
The problem of saving our global environment is going to absolutely depend on cooperation among countries.
Renewable energy is absolutely essential to solving the climate crisis.
It's not possible to tell people, stop using energy. They won't have transportation, they won't have heat, they won't have light, they won't have factories that produce the goods and services that we need. But how do we make both more energy available and less environmental impact? Well, one of the ways to do that is start substituting for oil other forms of energy and figure out cost-effective ways to produce that energy, to store that energy, and to move that energy in a way that doesn't take its toll on the environment.
It is supporting developing countries to scale renewable energy and also meet energy access needs.
The work we're doing is truly playing a long game, and the challenges we're working so hard to overcome won't be solved right away.
It's going to take philanthropy, it's going to also take government, it's going to take the private sector, it's going to take researchers, and it's going to take youth and students who are going to be the next generation in charge.
So empowering the next generation through STEM is absolutely essential to tackling our energy and climate challenges.
First Global has chosen to use the environment and energy in particular as our theme, because we believe showing kids all over the world the power of science and technology, coming up with the best ideas, deploying the best strategies, is the best hope the future has for saving our environment and still allowing people around the world to get the energy they need. It's all about connecting a global network of kids in a cooperation by which we hope they all learn how to communicate and recognize that they can learn from each other, they can work with each other, and they can create some new, really important solutions.
The new technology experience is something that we add to our robotics competition to give it a dimension that makes the kids understand that while playing with the robots is just plain fun, there's a much more serious consequence for what they do when they get involved. What I find most amazing is that kids that typically had little to no experience with any form of engineering or technology develop not only the skill sets but the confidence to try to attack some very, very, very difficult problems. And they do it with great enthusiasm, with great creativity. This year, the new technology experience, energy evolution, required the kids to take the technology that they were learning and apply it to solving a specific problem that they have dealing with energy. And that's exactly what these teams did.
Thinking in terms of science and robotics, I've been realizing that we need more novel solutions to save the planet. And I think the concept of the new technology experience perfectly aligns with this idea that we need a specific solution.
For me, it has developed our critical thinking skills about problems faced not just in our country but all over the globe. Because it has given us the compassionate heart to help the community, to help other people, and to address the problems that they are experiencing.
Looking at the game field, we can understand that there is renewable energy behind it. But this project helped us look in more detail and enhanced our comprehension. This new technology project really helped us understand how important it is to do something.
It offered us an opportunity to try and solve actual real-world problems using robots, to implement new solutions and to work towards new aims.
We chose the category of energy efficiency because it's quite well known that Australia isn't very energy efficient. We actually have 0.46 units of air conditioning per capita, which is insane. So we were like, this is a serious issue and we should definitely target this as one of the main focuses of our project. As a next generation, there have been so many new issues arising with the excessive amounts of energy we're using. It's just not sustainable enough for our world, and if we don't change something soon, we are going to have a huge, huge problem for us to deal with. I definitely thought that with some extra research and without extra thought going into this project, it has given us a new outlook on renewable energy. It doesn't have to be solar or hydro or even dependent on anything else. It could be as simple as just using soil and aluminium conductivity to release the heat back into the air.
We chose energy efficiency since we did lots of research for choosing our category. And we realized that energy efficiency is greatly lacking in the Republic of Moldova, our aim being to improve that. This whole new technology experience was a roller coaster for us. We had to build a prototype, disassemble it, and build it again. So we're really glad we're finalists in the top 10.
With a frequent blackout, rising electricity costs, and depending on imported petroleum, focusing on renewable energy was important.
Our project, born from the simplest idea, transformed into a real force for a positive change. This project aims to tackle Lebanon's energy crisis by harnessing solar panels in Hermel, an area in Lebanon, expected to meet 24.4% of the energy needed in Lebanon. This approach will cut carbon emissions by approximately 350,000 kilograms, and it coats only 13% of Lebanon's energy expense.
For this project, EcoGas, clean, green, and on the scene, it is a severe situation that is happening right now, and we're suffering from it. And that is exactly what makes this so special to my heart. We're talking about more than 4,000 families at a time. We actually made a system that digests and extracts seagrass, a renewable source of energy, to have eco-friendly gas in can via anaerobic digestion process. We're teenagers, we had no idea. Someone was there to help us, and I think that was the key for us to come up with this innovative idea. It makes me feel like, yes, that is the problem and that is the solution. We're doing something, we're changing something in this massive world. I feel my internal power, and you have to be there. You have to feel everything you're doing, and so you'll be impactful, and so then successful.
Your effort, no matter how small it seems, hold weight in shaping more sustainable future. Never underestimate the impact that you can make.
First Global has been so incredible. It's so amazing how you get to walk into this hall and there's people from over 190 countries all in the same room. I've definitely grown through this program because STEM has been life-changing. Before I joined FIRST, STEM was just another subject in class. But then after joining robotics, I've seen how I can utilize all those skills that I've learned into real-world application.
It's just shifted my perspective that if I try, if I do show my passion for making the world a better place and caring for the environment, we may actually come up with solutions that can save our planet.
FIRST Global is more than just the robotics or the competition. FIRST Global is like connecting the whole world through our passion, which we all share, for robotics and for STEM.
Being a part in FIRST Global Challenge has changed my life. It's not just about technical skills. It taught me to value collaboration, responsibilities, and making impact on global issues. It strengthened my belief in our ability that we can achieve anything using our knowledge.
When you look at the kids at the FIRST Global competition, and you see their energy and their enthusiasm and their passion to solve problems, it gives me great confidence that the future can be really exciting. We just have to support these kids. I think it proved to all of them that if they're willing to put some time and effort and energy into learning how to use technology, they can have a great future. We have to find ways to make sure that every parent, every teacher, every business leader, every community leader, every government organization, with some urgency, finds ways to make sure that all kids have the opportunity